Welcome to Joker's Wild, the channel that demonstrates dealer choice poker games for you to play on poker night with family and friends. Hit the subscribe and the notification bell so you never miss any games. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to play in between, or some people call it between the sheets. Start with a shuffled deck of cards. Determine your ante. I go with a higher ante in this game. If you normally ante a quarter, you should make this ante about $2. If you normally ante a dollar, your ante for this game should be around $5. On the first round, the most a player can take out of the pot is going to be whatever your ante is. So I'm going to ante $2, so the most anyone can bet in the first round is $2. I also announce there's a $5 max burn limit, which means $5 is the most you can lose. There could be $15 in the pot. Bet the pot. If you lose, the most you're going to pay is $5. If you don't put a limit on, I've seen a $10 pot grow to over $400 within 20 minutes. I'm going to start the game. You just flip over two up cards in the middle of the table. Action goes left of dealer clockwise around the table. And this player here, he can either bet or pass that the next card is going to fall in between these two cards. There's not many in between there, so he's just going to pass. Doesn't cost him anything. Next player's got a 9 and a 3. And we'll say he's just going to bet a quarter. He can bet a quarter up to $2 on this first round. Next card is a 4. It's in between, so he wins a quarter. Dealer's got an ace. Whenever the ace comes up first, you have a chance to call it high or low. If it's high, it's the highest card you can get. If you call it low, it equals the number one. If the ace falls second, the ace is always high. So I'm going to call this ace as being low, which would be number one. And let's see, from 1 to 7, there's a few cards in there. I'll bet 50 cents. Now this is called a bookend. If an ace would have came up or a 7, whatever these two cards here are, if an ace would come up or a 7 comes up, that's called a bookend. That means you pay double whatever you bet. So if you bet 50 cents, it costs you a dollar. If you bought a dollar, if you bet a dollar, it costs you $2. This player here, he's got a 5 and a 6. Well, those are consecutive numbers. If you have a 3-4, a 5-6, an ace-king, consecutive numbers mean you pay a quarter. You don't get a chance to make a bet, you just have to pay a quarter. Now we're over to this player here with a queen and a queen. Now you can split these for a quarter each. So it's going to cost him 50 cents, and he's going to split these two. So he's got a game right here. And we'll say he's going to go to a quarter on this one. So he wins a quarter on that game. This one over here, he has consecutives. Bummed out, he's got to pay a quarter. So if you want to split cards, you certainly can. It costs you a quarter for each card. And if you guys want to change that to maybe announce it when you're, you know, starting to deal this, that maybe splits are a dollar, you can make that whatever you guys want. I just usually play it as splits cost you a quarter each. Dealer's got a jack and a 4. A lot of cards in between there. I'll bet 50 cents on that. And I just hit a bookend. That means I bet 50, cost me a dollar. Now you can see if you don't put a max burn limit on here, let's say I would have bet $5. Now I got to pay 10. Now let's say there's $10 in the pot, and this guy here bets the pot, and he gets a bookend. Now he's got to pay 20. Now all of a sudden you have $30 in there. That's how this game can get out of control if you don't put a max burn limit on. This player over here, he's got a 7 and a 10. Not many cards in between there. He'll just pass. This player over here, he's got a jack and a 3. Quite a few cards in between there. We'll say he'll bet $2. It's an ace that's not in between. Costs him $2. Remember the second ace, whenever that falls, the second ace is always high. The first ace you can call high or low. Dealer's got a six and a second, seven consecutive numbers. Cost me a quarter. Player over here has got a four and a queen. Lots of cards in between there. And I'd say there's maybe, we'll take a guess here. Let's say there's $10 in the pot probably. Let's say he's going to go pot on this. He's betting the entire pot that this next card is in between. Let's say there's $10 here, but since I have a $5 max burn, if he loses, the most he has to pay is $5. That keeps this pot from getting out of control. And he just hit a bookend. So even though it's a bookend and you're supposed to pay double, the most you got to pay is $5. Well, you can see how this pot is growing already. I'm only playing with three guys. This game gets easily out of control if you don't put that burn limit on there. This player over here, he's got an ace. He can call it high or low. Let's say he calls it low. And that was no good luck, so he'll just pass. Dealer's got an eight and a five. Not many cards in between there. I'll just pass. Player over here has got a nine and a five. He'll pass on that. Player over here has got a six and an ace. Now this ace is high because it fell second. Quite a few cards in between there. We'll say he's going to bet the whole pot. He's got a chance to win maybe $15. Worst that can happen, it costs him five. And since the ace is high, that's not in between. Cost him $5. As you can see, the pot's growing pretty big. Dealer's got a 10 and a 9. Consecutive numbers, that just cost me a quarter. Player over here's got a deuce and an 8. Not real good chances. We'll say he's just going to go 50 cents on that. Good thing he didn't go too tall. Just cost him 50 cents. This player over here got an 8 and a 3. He'll pass. Dealer's got a king and a king. And I'll split those. Cost me 50 cents to split them. And I'll pass on that one. And I'll go a quarter on that one. I want a big quarter. So the way this game is going to end is someone's going to have to bet the entire pot and win it. And that ends the game. So we're over at this player right here with a 5 and a 5. And it's probably a good idea to split 5. So it costs 50 cents to split them. Ace is always high. So we'll say he's going to bet a dollar on that one. He wins a dollar, takes that out. This one over here, he's got a 5 and an 8, and he'll pass on that one. Player over here, he gets a 3 and a king. That's pretty darn good. Normally anybody would bet the pot on it, so we'll say he's going to bet the pot. Draws an 8. This player over here just won the entire pot. That ends the game. Take this game to your next poker night, try it out, comment down below and let me know how you guys like it, and thanks for watching.